Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how to use CP time data points to determine a molecule's half-life. For determining half-life, we're going to focus on the IV bolus of CP time data. On the left is CP time, and on the right is natural log CP versus time. The curve on the left shows that the molecule's concentration drops very sharply at first, and then the rate of decrease slows. This initial drop is called the distribution phase. The initial drop highlights the idea that the molecule, initially deposited into the blood, the plasma, very quickly circulates through the body and distributes into various tissues. During the distribution phase, CP drops primarily because the molecule is entering other tissues. It's not leaving the body. The length of the distribution phase varies, but it's often a matter of minutes. I've exaggerated the length of the distribution phase in these data to make it more clear. The remainder of the curve is called the elimination phase. During elimination, CP drops for two reasons. One is metabolism, and another is excretion. Both metabolism and excretion lead to drug clearance and cause elimination. When we go to the natural log CP time curve, we see that the elimination phase is essentially linear except for the short distribution phase. The slope of the line is equal to the negative of something called the elimination rate constant, or KEL, which is closely related to a molecule's half-life. We now have our raw data points as natural log, CP, and time. Again, these are the natural log values. In a spreadsheet, we can select the data points that are in the linear elimination phase, avoid the distribution phase points, and use the slope function in a spreadsheet to determine the slope of the line. Just type equal slope, and then first highlight your desired Y values. So column B, these are the column B values, and then the corresponding X values, that's column A, are time values, and press enter. Note that I am selecting just the later data points. These are the data points that correspond cleanly to the elimination phase. We are well clear of the distribution phase. In this case, the slope of our line is minus 0.051, so KEL is approximately plus 0.051, with units of inverse time, 1 over hours. To determine half-life, use a simple formula. T1 half equals 0.693 divided by KEL. In this case, half-life equals about 14 hours. Great. Determining the half-life of a molecule is just that easy. Fantastic. Before we get too excited, keep in mind that we just determined half-life in the rat. How does half-life in the rat help us understand half-life in humans? Well, people have found that molecules show a half-life in humans. It's often approximately 4 times the half-life of the rat. So this molecule would have a half-life in humans, or at least we'd expect it to have a half-life in humans, of around 60 hours. That's really long. As you might imagine, researchers have developed general correlations for other animal species as well, including monkeys and dogs. In general, half-lives increase as animals increase in mass. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment, or ask any questions that you might have. Take care.